Hello everyone, welcome to another video, and in this video I want to show you how you can automatically generate the fittings in case that you did use my previous script in which you could automatically generate straight sections, and also in that script you would also have some elbows. So when you typically use that script to generate the elements from the AutoCAD, you will have some results like this. And what is the problem over here, and what I did try to resolve with this new script is, okay, you did use the script to generate installations, but now it can happen that for some element, and we have three different cases, so it doesn't matter if it's a pipe, cable tray or duct, it can happen that somebody into AutoCAD did draw two or maybe more lines for one element. So in the Revit it is easy that we just click to that extend command, and then we will click on the both elements and then we will connect them. But when you have, let's say, 100 of those situation, then maybe it is good to try to apply some automatic. Also, what we don't have over here are the T connection, and again, if you have 200 elements that you need to connect, it would be great if you can use some script to help you with that. So let's run the script and we will see the results. Let's begin with the pipe. So over here we have two elements instead of one, also over here. So I will run the script, and the user interface, it's very simple. So we need to choose if we want to run this script for a cable tray, duct or pipe. Let's say that we want to run for the pipe. And let's say that at first we want to resolve those problems. And now this is not so simple inside the Dynamo. So in order to keep connectivity, so let's can go undo. Just to show you one thing. So in order to keep connectivity between the elements, so over here those elements are not connected, but this element was connected to this elbow also over here. So this element was connected to this elbow over here, and we want that when we delete those two elements and when we create one new element, we also want that that new element is connected to those elbows. So let's run the script again. So it is a pipe, we want to extend. I will talk about this a bit later. So now instead of that two elements, we will have one, and we did keep that connectivity. So now if we move this pipe, those elements will also move along. Okay, we did also, I'm not sure what is this, but the element is connected. So if we move this element, there is something over here, I'm not sure what, but the elements are connected. Okay, now let's try to add those T elements. Now, because of the methodology, how Dynamo will try to find and connect the elements, it can happen that maybe you will need to run this script a couple of times, because inside the Dynamo you need basically to slice this element to a couple of different elements in order to connect them all. So we want to apply the script for the pipes, and we want to create T fittings. You can see that we did create over here, over here, I don't know, over here, I don't know if it, and all those three fittings over here, but over here we didn't, and over here we didn't create. Over here there is a T, but there is some problem with connectivity. And okay, over here we don't have, over here we don't have, and also over here. Let's run the script again. So again it's a pipe, again it's a T, and now we have on all those places except here that T thing. Okay, over here we would need to do this manually. Okay, but for the pipes, everything that is remained are the open connections. Now let's try to apply the same for the cable tray. So on the cable tray, when script delete two elements and when the script need to create one new element, when you don't have an elbow, usually in the pipes and ducts, those two points on the end or start of the cable tray will be very close. But for the ducts and cable trays, it can happen because those are large elements that you will need to apply some margin. And I will show you that. So cable tray, let's say again that we want at first to extend. What will happen? We did resolve this element over here. Over here we have one element, but that one margin, 1 millimeter margin was not sufficient. So we need to increase that margin. So I will go redo. Okay, let's run the script again. And let's say that now we want to have a margin of 100 millimeters. And now the script works. It can happen that that command does not work on your side and for some other examples. For me, it was important that for this particular example, I can see that this solution works. And for some other situation, I'm pretty sure that you can modify the script in a way that the script would work also for other cases. Just I didn't have enough time to test, but I think this just showed that it is possible to create automatic solution for this extend command. Okay, now we need also to apply those T fittings for the cable trays. We'll try once for a couple of places we have T fittings. For some cable trays we don't have a T. Set values. Now everything looks okay again except this one. Now it is okay. And finally for the ducts, it is the same story, but you don't need to increase the margin. So ducts, extend, set values, one element, and over here we have one element. Also we need to create those T's. And now we will just check if those connections are actually connections. So I will just move a little bit over here. I will turn on show disconnects also for the ducts and cable trays. So you can see over here, same as for the pipe. For some reason, over here we don't have connection. Everything else is connected. So if I move this duct, it will move the others also over here. There is a lot of space for improvement of this script. Again, if we move this cable tray, it will move the others, and same for the pipes. So this is just some script to help you a little bit with automatic creation of the fittings. If you did use the AutoCAD for generation of those installations. Now I will show you the script in Dynamo. Thank you for watching.